Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, gross profit percentage, watch the video till the end. And also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. Let's begin with today's topic, that is the gross profit percentage formula. So the gross profit percentage formula, percentage is the formula which is used by the, we call as the management, the investors, basically, and the financial analyst to know the financial health and basically the profitability of the company. After the accounting for the cost of sales is calculated by dividing the gross profit of the company by its net sales. So first of all, what is the gross profit percentage? Let's study this. See, the gross profit percentage is a measure of the profitability that calculates how much of every dollar of the revenue is left over after paying off the cost of goods sold. So in other words, it measures the efficiency of the company in utilizing the inputs of the costs of production, such as like raw material and labor, in order to produce and sell its products profitably. It can be seen as a percent of the sales that exceeds the direct costs associated with the manufacturing and product. So these direct costs, or so-called as COGS, primarily consist of raw materials and direct labor. The calculation of the gross profit percentage formula is done by dividing the gross profit. Okay, you can say the gross profit percentage formula is done by dividing the gross profit by the total sales and expressed in the percentage terms. Well, let's understand the margin formula here. The gross profit percentage is represented by the gross profit percentage formula is equal to gross profit divided by the total sales into 100%. So it can be further be expanded as the gross profit percentage formula is the total sales less the cost of goods sold divided by the total sales into 100%. So the money that is remaining after covering the COGS is used for the services and other operating expenses, like selling, commission expenses, and so on and so forth. The general and admin expense, research and development, marketing expense, interest expense, that appears further below in the income statement. So as such, these the higher it is better for the company to pay off its operating expense for the business. Let's understand the steps to determine the GP percentage. Well, the calculation of the GP percentage formula can be simply be done by using the following steps. Step number one is that you know the total sales of the company, okay, which is easily available as a line item in the income statement. Second, now next, gather the COGS directly from the income statement or compute the COGS by adding the direct cost of manufacturing, such as raw material, labor, wages, and so on and so forth. Third, next is the gross profit is calculated by deducting the COGS from the total sales. That is, the gross profit is equal to the total sales minus the COGS. Step number four. Finally, it is calculated by dividing the gross profit by the total sales that is shown, and it is expressed in the percentage that name suggests. So the gross profit percentage formula is equal to your total sales less the COGS divided by the total sales into 100%. Let's understand this with the help of an example. Let's understand the concept with the help of a simple example to understand it better. Example number one. Let us consider an example of a company called XYZ Limited for doing the calculation of gross profit. The XYZ Limited is a business of into manufacturing customized roller skates for both the professional and the amateur skaters. So at the end of the financial year, XYZ Limited has earned, let's say, around 1,50,000 in total, okay, net sales during the along with the following expenses. So as per the question, based on the below information over which I'm going to provide, we will do the calculation of the gross profit percentages. First of all, labor, raw material, factory rent, interest, depreciation, and then taxes. I'm gonna note down numbers for each of them. 50,000, 25,000, 5,000, 10,000, 15, and 5. So by using the above data, we will first calculate the cost of goods sold. The COGS is equal to your labor wages plus your raw material expense plus your factory rent. That is equal to 50 plus 25,000 plus 5,000. That comes down to 80,000. So that's your COGS. So only those costs are taken into computation of the COGS, which can be directly be allocated to the production. And now we will calculate the gross profit by using the given data somewhere closely like this. The gross profit is equal to your total sales, that was 1,50,000 in the initial, less the COGS, that is 80,000, which we calculated a minute back. So our gross profit is 70,000, and therefore the calculation of the gross profit percentage of the XYZ Limited will be, it's called the GP percentage, 70,000 divided by 1,50,000 into 100%. It comes down to closely around 46.67%. So XYZ Limited gross profit percentage for the year stood at 47%. Let's do example number 2. Now let us take the example of the Apple Inc. for the gross profit percentage calculation for the fiscal year 2016, 17, 2018. As per the annual report, the information that can be available based on the details, it's going to be the net sales 2016, 2017, and 2018. Well, the net sales over here, we are going to put down 215,639, 229, 234, 265,595. Then the cost of sales, that is 131,376, 141,048, and 163,756. So by using the above data, we will be first calculate the gross profit of the Apple Inc. for the year 2016. The gross profit is the gross profit 2016 is equal to net sales minus the cost of the goods sold. So it's as simple as that. This is your gross profit, GP. Okay. This is your gross profit. Then the gross profit for 2017 and then 2018. Right? So we have found all the numbers. And you know how we calculate gross profit divided by the sales, the GP percentage is equal to your gross profit divided by sales into 100%. Control R, convert this into percentage, and there we go. We have all our answers. Now, I want to make you understand first what exactly is the relevance and uses of this formula. See, the understanding of it is, this is very important for an investor because it shows how much profitable is the core business activities of the company are without taking into consideration any sort of indirect costs. Okay, so an analyst can use these ratios, especially as an assessment metric, to compare the operating performance of the company with other players within the same industry and sector. It also, the companies use these ratios as an indication, okay, of the financial benefit and the viability of a particular product or services. See, any money that is left over after covering the COGS is used to pay off the other operating expenses. In simple words, higher it is, more the company saves on each of the dollar of the sales and service and other operating costs in the business obligation. So if a company is capable of sustaining materially higher gross profit margin compared to the most of the other peers always, it means that it has more efficient processes and more efficient operations that makes it safe long-term investment. On the other hand, if you see a company is not able to earn, let's say, adequate gross profit percentage, it may be difficult for such a company to pay off its operating expenses. And as such, the gross profit percentage of a company should be stable unless and until there are some major changes done by the company's business model. That's it for this particular topic. Thank you everyone for once again for joining the session. Cheers. If you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, please like, comment and subscribe to our channel. And thank you everyone.